Good evening. Welcome to the evening service at Caterham Baptist Church. Thank you very much for watching this video. It's not going to be a normal evening service in the sense that we're going to spend a little more time singing and praising God for what he has done. Maybe that's a bit harder at the moment than it normally is, because it's easy to praise God when things are going well, but let's face it, at the moment, they're not going particularly well, are they? You know, we're going through a situation that many of us have never seen in our lifetimes before. And it's hard. How do we praise God in times of trouble? Now, that's what I've called this evening, praising God in times of trouble. And what I want to look at tonight is how we can keep on praising God even when times are hard. So let's begin with a prayer. Lord, we thank you. We thank you that you are with us, that you sustain us and support us. Lord, you do that when times are well, but you do that when we go through times of trouble as well. And maybe particularly in those times we can turn to you, knowing that you are our sure foundation, that you are the rock on which our lives can depend. And so we thank you, Lord, and we praise you for what you have done. And we turn to you now. Amen. So we're going to begin by singing a great song. And it may be that you can't sing out loud where you are, but if you can, I encourage you to do so. But if you can't sing out loud where you are at the moment, then as the words come up, maybe just speak them quietly and reflect upon what they say. It's a great hymn because in the second verse, it really talks about being in times of difficulty, in times of trouble. And it says, in every condition, in sickness and health, in poverty's grip, or abounding in wealth. And it says, you know, wherever we are, land or sea or whatever, shall your strength be. Meaning, God's strength is with us wherever we are and in whatever situation we are. So great hymn. So let's join together and sing our first song.
Thank you.
In our home groups, we've been studying the letter of 1 Peter. And in that letter, Peter begins in verse 3 by writing this: "Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he's given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead." Peter encourages his readers to praise God, to praise God the Father for his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who's given us new birth. And we're going to remind ourselves of that by singing two songs. Now, firstly, we're going to remind ourselves that Jesus is the name that we honor and that we need to glorify him and lift him high. And then following on from that, we're going to remind ourselves as well of what we have received. Who am I that the highest king would welcome me?
Thank you.
Book of Isaiah, the prophet writes this in chapter 42. He says, "Sing to the Lord a new song, his praise from the ends of the earth." And we're going to sing a couple of new songs now, particularly brought to us by our young people. So firstly, we're going to sing "Our God," with that great chorus that says, "Our God is greater. Our God is stronger." Because he is greater and stronger than any situation around us. And then following on from that, we're going to sing "Waymaker," reminding ourselves that Jesus is the path through which we come to God. Let's join with the young people now and sing with them as again we praise God.
We're now going to sing Our God.
I worship you. You are here, waiting every heart, and I worship you, I worship you, Lord. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
So I don't know if you've ever come across the phrase caught between a rock and a hard place. Apparently the phrase came from the States, came from a situation where some copper miners were concerned about their pay and about the conditions they were working under, and went to the management of the copper mine and explained their requirements, and the management refused them and said, no, unless you go back to work, you'll lose your jobs and you will have no work whatsoever. And so those miners were described as being caught between a rock, meaning going back to work and mining the copper, and a hard place, losing their jobs. It's a phrase that we know, but I'm wondering whether someone like David would have been able to relate to that. You see, when we read the story of David in the Bible, there's certain situations where David is clearly caught between a rock and a hard place. There's this situation in 1 Samuel 21, where Saul has been chasing David and trying to kill him. Now, we always think that David's always able to get away from Saul. He's like some kind of Robin Hood character who manages to slip away at the last minute and Saul never catches him. But when you read the accounts in 1 Samuel, it becomes clear that there were times that David was terrified for his life. And actually, this situation is one of those, because David is so afraid of Saul and being captured and put to death that he actually goes for shelter to the Philistines. And he goes and lives in a Philistine town. And the Philistines become aware that David is there. And they say, hang on, this is David who has killed many of our people. And suddenly David is in fear of his life there as well. David is caught between a rock and a hard place. And he manages to get out of that situation as well. Good story if you ever want to read that one. But the amazing thing is that when David is in that situation, when he's being chased by Saul, and yet at the same time, he's living for fear of his life amongst the Philistines, David writes a psalm. And he writes a psalm about praising God in times of trouble. You see, it's easy to write a psalm that praises God when you've come through the other side. And you can write a psalm and say, yes, I can now praise God because I've come through that time of trouble. But it appears that David wrote this psalm whilst he was in a time of trouble. So we're just going to briefly look at that psalm, Psalm 34. So let's just hear what that psalm has to say.
Psalm 34, verses 1 to 4. I will extol the Lord at all times. His praise will always be on my lips. I will glory in the Lord. Let the afflicted hear and rejoice. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord and he answered me. He delivered me from all of my fears.
So I want to look at four really quick, simple points from the beginning of that psalm, those first four verses. So verse one, David writes this, he says, I will extol the Lord at all times. His praise will always be on my lips. You see, David gets this. He knows that it's not just about praising God when things are going well. He says, I'm going to praise God at all times, whether times are going well or whether times are going bad. I guess the bit that that reminds me of in the Bible is that passage in Acts 16. Paul and Silas have been arrested and placed in prison. And the writer tells us this. He says, about midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. I always wonder about the other prisoners, just hoping that Paul and Silas might eventually be quiet so they could actually get some sleep. But it was amazing because Paul and Silas, even though they were in prison, even though they were in a terrible situation, still managed to pray and sing hymns to God. They were praising God at all times, not just when it was going well. Verse 2, David writes this, I will glory in the Lord. Let the afflicted hear and rejoice. You see, David doesn't want to just praise God about his own situation and about that God is looking after him. He says, look, I know that some of you are going through similar situations, and maybe David had taken some of his men with him and they were living amongst the Philistines with him and they were in fear of their lives as well. And David says, no, I am going to praise God in this situation so that those who are in trouble as well can hear and rejoice. You see, part of being a Christian is that we praise God and that we encourage other people as well in hard times because they hear us praising God. Verse 3, he says, glorify the Lord with me. Let's exalt his name together. See, he says, let's join together and praise God. Now, that's hard for us to do. You know, we're sat at home. We can't easily join together as a congregation. And, you know, we feel that because we want to. We want to come together and lift our voices in song and praise God. But the wonder of modern technology means that we can do it like this. And we can sing in home at our homes or just speak along with the songs as they're coming up, knowing that around Caterham, our brothers and sisters are doing the same and are praising God with us as well. So even though we can't physically meet together, let's exalt Jesus' name together. And then fourthly, I sought the Lord and he answered me. He delivered me from all my fears. Now, I love that verse. You see, David doesn't say he delivered me from my problems. David doesn't say God took away the threat. What he actually says is this, he delivered me from all my fears. What I am afraid of. God answers. He doesn't necessarily take away the problem, but he delivers us from our fears. Daniel, in the book of Daniel, we hear the account of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And they refuse to bow down to this idol that the king has set up, and so they're taken to be thrown into the fiery furnace. And as they stand there before the king, and he gives them one last opportunity, they turn around to him and they say something remarkable. They say, if we are thrown into the blazing furnace, the God we serve is able to deliver us from it. and he will deliver us from your majesty's hand. But even if he does not, we want you to know, your majesty, we will not serve your gods or worship the image of gold you set up. You see, for Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego, they didn't know what was going to happen. But like David, they could say this: God delivers me from all my fears. They were not afraid. They trusted in him. Maybe that's what we need to hear as we go through difficult times. How do we praise God in times of trouble? We remind ourselves of what he has done. We remind ourselves of the power that he has. And we say, look, his praise will be on my lips, good times or bad times. The afflicted will hear and rejoice. I'm going to make sure that when I praise God, those in similar situations will hear and be encouraged. I join together with other believers when I can, whether online or physically at some point, and praise God like that. And I know that God answers me and he will deliver me from my fears. So we're going to close by singing a final hymn and remind ourselves again of what we have received. I think it's when we remember what God has done for us that truly we experience and understand the grace we've received. So let's join together in singing, "There is an everlasting kindness lavished on us."
Your face at the thorns of
Thank you for joining us this evening. So let's close now with a prayer. Lord, we thank you. We thank you that we can come before you and praise your name. Lord, we thank you that we can praise you when things are going well, but even more that we can praise you when things are not going so well. And Lord, we pray that as we go into this week, we will remember the grace and the mercy that we have received from you, that we will remember that your Son came to this earth to live amongst us, to die on the cross and be raised again, so that we may know your salvation. And Lord, as a result of that, we may be able to praise you in times of trouble. Amen.